Welcome into the Jones Center here in Springdale, Arkansas, for round two of the bout between the McKendree Bearcats and your Arkansas Razorbacks. EJ Sanders on the call, Quinn Shields on the camera here today at the Jones Center. A beautiful day outside, a little brisk, but that Arkansas fall is moving in as Arkansas gets ready to take on McKendree. Last night, they won the game in overtime, 3-2, an overtime winner by Alex Parisi. Sealed the game for the Hogs after being outplayed in the third period by this McKendree Bearcats team. Arkansas getting stretched out, getting ready to go. Corey Rees getting the start along with Tyler Valdrin. That's Dylan Odeline over there. Grant Deacon, Aiden Everett, and Griffin Sugasawara will be the top line tonight for the Arkansas Razorbacks. Meanwhile, on the other side, it looks like they're going to go with Blandina, Brilli, and Wolf on the top line, as well as Feltus and DiBiase on the defensive end. The ref with his arm in the air, the only puck drop he'll participate in all night, and it's one back here by Arkansas. They'll dump one into the zone and get the fresh start that they're looking for. Arkansas looking for some offensive zone time as Griffin Sugasawara takes a hit in the corner there from DiBiase. They're fighting for it on the far side boards. McKendree's going to break it out of the zone. They'll send one down the ice, and they send a couple of fast skaters after it, including Wolf. Wolf takes a hit in the corner there by Rees. Rees with an emergency stick to start this game as he broke it during warm-ups. This one's passed back off. That's alternate captain here, Aiden Everett. He's going to send this one into the zone. He gets met there with a punch to the back of the head by Feltus. McKendree not messing around here early. They'll send this one back to the point. They got a man there. Shot back down into the corner there by Valdrin. Backhanded along. Deacon on the near side shut down there by the goaltender as Arkansas fires it back into the zone. They'll backhand one off the boards. Picked up here by Valdrin. And back to the point. Valdrin chasing after it. Farinetta caught out of position and back the other direction. Comes McKendree. They'll fire a shot. Rebound out front. Arkansas able to steer it to the corner. 18:55 to go in the first period. A backhand pass by Palmer. Deacon cross ice to Sugasawara. He gets the better of a hit there that was lined up by Nick Nelson. Arkansas dumps it into the zone. Sugasawara, not big in stature at 5'10", 150, but able to level a man charging his way. 5'9", 195, Nick Nelson. Face off to the left of the goaltender here. It's one back to the point. Arkansas is going to play it back down low. They'll send it around the boards. Looks like Bernardini's getting the start net again. It's played back around the goal. Picked up here by Arkansas. They'll shove one along. McLean back around the boards. It's gloved down there by Farinetta. Back to McLean. Low circle. Tries to work his way through. Puck lost in his skates and covered up there by Joey Bernardini. 18:19 to go in the first. Arkansas with the majority of the chances early. Last night we saw McKendree's goals come when Arkansas was sleeping on the defensive end. McKendree, a very fast skating team, deceptively fast, in fact, as Arkansas skating into the zone, a late change there by Branscombe. Palmer skating it around the boards. He'll send this one down into the corner, far side. Watched through the crease there by Bernardini. A pass down low. McLean's shot goes well wide. Picked up here by Palmer, who'll fire a shot well wide of the goal as well. This one down low. Valdrin's going to send it back around the boards and picked up there by Gay. Nick Gay, 6'8" is what he's listed. He'll send one to the near side, looking to break out of the zone. They've got a breakout pass. That's Reek into the offensive zone. Reek picks up the puck. Centering pass goes off the pad of Kalmus. He's able to make the save. Moore's trying to break it out, but he can't. Glovko with the puck. A pass broken up there by Moore. Moore, stick lift, has his man pinned down in the corner, trying to skate that one along. Is Glovko sent to the far side, Arkansas to break out. McLean will go for a change as Branscombe loses the puck in the neutral zone, and it's sent back down into the Arkansas zone. Bearcats giving chase. Grosso lays a hit on there on Valdrin. Valdrin, a cross-ice pass, skated down, a turnover offensive zone. Nelson takes the brunt of that hit, though, as Valdrin knocks him off the puck. Bohr with Jackson, two on two the other way, and a back checker on the rebound scores. What a shot by Brooks Moore. Rebound off of Jackson's shot. Jackson will get awarded an assist on that play. And Arkansas takes the early one-goal lead. Now, last night, McKendree got on the board first despite the early Arkansas chances. But Arkansas
answers the bell tonight.
Scored the last two goals in the series, including the OT winner last night. Kendry scored first yesterday. Arkansas answered with two of their own, held that score through the second period and through most of the third period before McKendry tied it up. And then in overtime with 27 seconds on the clock, Alex Parisi was able to finish the game for everybody involved and send the Hogs fans home happy. A lighter crowd tonight as the Vanderbilt game is on. Hogs football team in action, looking to get their third win of the year. Meanwhile, these Ice Hogs are searching for their 10th win already in just 12 games. In their 12th appearance this year, as this faceoff's won forward by McKendry, a little wraparound opportunity is picked up here by Odeline. He'll back skate over into the corner. A centering pass just finds Kalmus's paddle in front of the net. Another shot, rebound left there off the blocker. Picked up, skating around the boards, and Arkansas's trying to get it out of the zone but cannot. Poole gets it back, sends it down to the far side corner. Arkansas looks a little lethargic out here early despite getting the early goal. Wheeler can't get the puck away. A shot from a tough angle, but Kalmus has a sure glove. Derek Northrup, no chance on that one. He stands at 5'7", 135. 16 and a half minutes to play here in the first period. More from Jackson as they announce it on the loudspeaker. Deacon to take the faceoff. He'll tie a man up here. Arkansas is going to get the puck out of the zone as it just trickles over the line. Everett giving chase. He's back checking on Grimminger. Grimminger, an excellent game last night, was all over the ice for the Bearcats. Arkansas did all they could last night to slow him down, and he would not be halted. Speaking of halting, Arkansas sends that puck over the boards. That'll bring a faceoff outside the zone. 3 minutes and some change gone here. In this first period, Arkansas already on the board. This one won back by McKendry. They'll send this one into the zone. A little tip in by Wolf. This one's picked up by Marsh. Marsh tries to send it around the boards. Wolf sends it in front. Had a man on the back post but couldn't finish it off. Was Blandina. Arkansas sends it back the other way. A little pong game going on. So they go back and forth here. And finally settled down here by the Hogs. Nice pass out there by Higgins. Higgins gets it out of the zone, but no further as Grimminger picks it up, but he'll turn it over. Sugasawara couldn't get his balance, and Grimminger's able to get the puck back. Near side boards, the Bearcats to break out. Arkansas stole the puck away, but Farinetta ran into his own man entering the zone. Got tangled up. Grimminger, a tough-angled shot. Easily saved there by Kalmus. Deacon shielding his goaltender from any further trouble after that. Whistle. 4 minutes, 25 seconds gone. We talked last night about how the Bearcats have an excellent top six guys. Talked about their speed and how deceptive they are. And they like to stretch the ice. Arkansas on the tie up here. It's one back out front. Down low, a little wheeling backhand. Saved there by Kalmus. Puck loose for a second and finally smothered. Nice little move down low there by Garrett Poole. He had 9 goals, 24 assists last season, 33 total points in only 21 games. That's efficiency. Anytime you're scoring more than a point a game, as this one comes back to the point, Arkansas settles the puck down. A little outlet pass looking for Farinetta. Farinetta leaves it there for McLean. McLean, offensive zone, high circle, fires a shot, blockered up into the netting and out of play. That one looked like it might have come back down onto the ice, but just barely clears the boards. Arkansas will have an offensive zone faceoff. Just fighting that one off. Faceoff will come to the right. It's one ahead here by McKendry. They'll skate it into the zone, send it across the blue line. They're saying it's offside. They'll have to clear that. The captain, Palmer, picks it up, finds Valdrin far side. He'll clear the zone, but turning it right back the other direction comes Nelson. Nelson, offensive zone, sorry. He'll fire a shot. A low pad save by Kalmus. Rebound was there. Arkansas clears it aside. That was Golovko, I should say, on that. And Arkansas has a delayed penalty here. I should say McKendry's delayed penalty. Arkansas with the puck. They'll get a sixth attacker on the ice. Cross ice pass goes off the boot of McLean down the ice. No icing, and they'll touch up. We have a penalty. First of the game. For hooking. Dmytro Golovko from Kiev, Ukraine. Saying it was icing, so the icing nullifies Arkansas's offensive zone faceoff, but it won't be a defensive zone faceoff because of the penalty. It comes outside the Arkansas zone. Strange how hockey works sometimes. They advance it one dot. Arkansas wins this back. Reese, as we mentioned earlier, with the emergency stick out there. He's got Odelein behind the cage. Odelein kind of stumbles a bit coming out from behind the cage. He'll send one near side. Deacon with a head of steam. Far side, a lot of space to work with. High circle on the far side of the ice. He's got it. Offensive zone for Arkansas. He lays one off, and Odelein struggles handling that one and sent back down the ice by Poole. Good defensive play there by Garrett Poole, the sophomore. As Arkansas will turn it back the other direction. 6 minutes gone here. A minute and a half left on the penalty. Reese getting acclimated back behind his own net. Reese looking to break out near side. He's got a man looking for Odelein just out of his reach. Goes down the ice. No icing. McKendry player had a chance at it. Arkansas will get it back in the corner. Got the puck back to Reese at the point. He'll send it back down in the near side hash. Odelein. Odelein with it. Outer hash. He sends it now below the goal line and then banks one off the boards back to Reese at the point. Right-handed stick. Sends it to Odelein again. They're just rotating it around. A little tic-tac passing. Tries to work through a defender. Odelein not able to do so, and it gets sent back down the ice there by Poole. Poole, been a one-man crew on this penalty kill as Reese is trying to get past a man. It's slowed up a little bit. Blandina, very fast skater on the ice. Arkansas has to match McKendry's speed with their physicality. It cannot be deterred. McKendry's got a couple of guys themselves, though. They're over 6'5", so it is what it is on that end. It's Palmer. Sends this one into the zone. He'll skate it in. He's got it high circle. Lays a pass off. Caught in the skates of Parisi. Nice job keeping that one in. High circle again. Shoots it through the traffic. Save down in front. Face off will come to the right. Bernardini in goal again tonight. He's proven himself early this year, holding that 2.5 GAA. And they'll send another McKendry Bearcat to the box here. McKendry arguing. On the ice for the Bearcats here as the faceoff comes to the right. A 5-on-3 power play for 12 seconds for Arkansas. They need to work quickly. They'll win this one back to the point. This is Valdrin. Valdrin's got Palmer near side. Palmer lines a shot up. Hit, he'll score. He knocks the water bottle off. And that is a 5-on-3 power play goal, which means they'll still have the remainder of the 5-on-4. A 2-0 lead for Arkansas as Zach Palmer extends the early advantage for Arkansas. 12:44 to play in the first. Chelsea dagger ringing through the Jones Center ice. The Fratellis. The noted goal song of the Chicago Blackhawks. Very popular goal song. So this one's sent back down into the zone. Arkansas will retrieve it there, still on the power play. McKendry seems to up their pressure, though, here. They don't want to get behind three goals here as Parisi skates it into the zone, works by one guy, passes it out front. What a save by Bernardini. He shuts down the opportunity on the back post by McLean. Looked like he had all the time in the world to put that one in, but did not. Arkansas holds the blue line, sends it back down into the zone, 1:22 to go on the power play. Instead, they'll have to clear the offside. Palmer sends it back down around the boards. Bernardini steps out but just watches it go by. Sent back down the ice. Palmer gives chase. Going after it also is Garrett Poole. Poole trying to pick this puck up. Everett has it. He's got a man far side. That's Palmer. Palmer tried to pass one back off for Everett. He'll have to retreat now. It's the back checking Northrup. Gets him, and a big hit laid on Sugasawara in the corner. He is undeterred. He's going to go after the puck. He's right in the hip pocket of Poole, but blows a tire. Arkansas gloves that one down. Reese will have to turn around. 45 seconds left in the Arkansas power play. Arkansas's power play has been pretty good this year, scoring almost over a quarter of the time. Arkansas still with the puck. They're going to bank one along. Everett and Sugasawara down there. Sugasawara sends it along. Hits a broken stick that's laying on the ice. Arkansas picks this one back up. Deacon with it. Deacon has Reese at the point. A lot of broken sticks so far today. Speaking a lot to the physicality of this game early on. 17 seconds left in the Arkansas power play. Back to the point. Reese lining one up. Fires a shot well high off the stick of Brilli and into the netting surrounding the Jones Center ice. He stands, crowd the ice here at the Jones Center. That protective netting does just that. That net extends all the way from the goal line on the opposite side of the ice, rings all the way around to the near side where the fans sit, and goes all the way to the other side. Arkansas will win this faceoff back. Picked up here. Sugasawara having a tough time controlling that one as the penalty comes to a close. 2 seconds, now one. A huge hit laid on there by Odeline. Causes a man to stumble and fall. That was Brown. This is Reese with it. Got a man near side, Odeline. Odeline looking up the ice. Nice little deke there. A little skate ahead. Tries a toe drag there at the end of that. Couldn't string the moves together. And back the other way comes Blandina. He'll fire a shot. Blocked down by Everett up into the netting. There's a certain decorum that hockey players have out there on the ice. There's a set of rules that are unspoken that you won't find anywhere in the rule book. And these two teams, very civil for the most part, as Arkansas skates this one into the zone. This is Moore with it on the circle on the far side. Lines up a shot. Nice save by Bernardini. He'll try to backhand one along, but a little stick lift there by Brilli, and he'll skate it out of the zone. Brilli with a lot of steam. He's got a man on the back post. Passes one off. Couldn't find him. An Arkansas player blows the tire over there. That was Marsh. Arkansas trying to recover, but the puck comes free down low. Dalton Wolf to pick that one up. Wolf lays a hit on a man down there in the corner. That was Marsh. Headhunting there was Golovko. Arkansas looking for the puck again. This is Moore. He backhands a pass on net. Easy there, Moore. .951 to go. Face off to the right of the goaltender. Waldron just dumps that one back into the zone. Golovko off the boards, banks one along. It's passed ahead. Arkansas not going to touch that one until they clear the offside. Waldron with it. He's got a man near side, Palmer. He's got the Valentini line out there, including Wheeler and Tilson. Arkansas stealing this one away at the blue line. A little pass back down low, finds his man. Struggling to control that one was Tilson. He's going to have to regain his feet. As Palmer's back skating here. A shot blocked down by Arkansas. Glove down there by Waldron. Shields a couple of men off the puck, including Reek. Arkansas trying to come away with it. This one comes back to the point. Shot in front of the net. Nobody home for McKendry to finish that one off. And here comes Waldron the other direction. Waldron stick handling. He's got a man trailing him. That's Valentini. He opts to send this one around the boards. Far side, Tilson to pick it up there. Tilson a utility player, a guy who can play forward or defense. As that puck comes out of the zone, Palmer's going to pick it up here. He's got Valdrin near side. Valdrin's going to wind up a slapper, goes wide of the net, and takes an odd bounce off the lower boards and up in to the protective netting. 8:43 to go in the first. Two to nothing. You see that in the top left corner of your screen. Arkansas in the white uniforms with the red shoulder yoke, the black pants and the white socks with the red stripes. They're skating from your left to right. McKendry in the darker uniforms, the purple with the black yoke and the black pants, are skating from right to left. Arkansas, new uniforms sported this year. Got the names on the back as the D-to-D pass is broken up here near side. McKendry, tough forecheck there, and the puck comes loose out front. Nelson couldn't finish that one off. Far side of the ice, Arkansas skating out with it. McLean just chips and chases here. He's going to dump it down into the corner. Gay shields him off the puck. Arkansas can't control it behind the net. McKendry will settle it down. They've got a man near side. They're going to try a cross-ice pass. Has a man in the center of the ice into the offensive zone. Skating through a man is Nelson, but sticked away easily. Job by Odeline. Odeline sends it high and out of play. Unfortunate bounce there off the boards. Odeline likes to use that Z axis when moving the puck. Sometimes lifts it a little too high in the air. These boards here are not very tall. Not a whole lot of room for error when clearing the puck here at the Jones Center. A smaller ice, affectionately called the shoebox. By Arkansas's longtime coach Galini. Turnover, offensive zone, skating through the traffic is Northrop. He goes spinning down. Arkansas will get the puck back. Ran into a couple of Arkansas defenders as Everett sends this one high into the zone. That puck flies in. A centering pass there by Sugasawara. Marsh is going to pick this one up. He'll bank it hard off the boards. Around back. Picked up there by Poole. Poole's going to make a turning move. Has a man on the outlet pass. Turnover again by McKendry. Unlike them, last night, very clean getting the puck in and out of the zone. Deacon checks up the offside. Deacon's going to want to change here soon. Arkansas sends this one around. Deacon finally goes for a change. Higgins on the ice now for Arkansas. Moore chips it off the boards. Higgins a quick change as Everett gets into the offensive zone. He's got stick handling move. He fires a shot. Rebound there. No. Was able to be snatched up. Looked like the puck came free for a second. But able to regain control of it was Bernardini. And with 7 minutes to go in the first period, Arkansas clings to their two-goal lead. The Jones Center, nearly 20 years old. It's been around for a while. Arkansas has been sporting a team here at the Jones Center, at least one team. They now have two since the mid-aughts. About 2006, 2007, somewhere around there. Arkansas got themselves a hockey team, and ever since then, they've been hanging banners in the SECHC, this Division III team. Skating out of the zone comes McKendry. Back and forth, a little pat back and forth as Arkansas is going to get this puck. Offensive zone, Branscombe dumps it in deep. Skating after it hard there was Brown. Brown looking out the far side, and Arkansas has a delayed penalty. Branscombe arguing the call. Picks up his stick that came loose on that penalty and a turnover in front of the net. That's too bad, too. Arkansas would have had an opportunity right there. Instead, they will have to kill off a penalty. Last night, they were excellent killing off all of their penalties that they had. Six of them, to be sure. McKendry could really use a power play goal, under 10%. They're getting to that point. Arkansas continues to take penalties. They're getting to that point where McKendry's going to be due. Arkansas a little better on their power play, scoring on one out of every four or so. They've already scored one power play goal today as McKendry loses the puck. out of the scrum. Back down, near side circle, holding on to it there is Nelson. He'll send it back to the point as Grimminger. Grimminger to Nelson. Outer hashes, near side circle. Cross-ice pass broken up there by Odeline. Trying to shove it out of the zone. There's Valentini. Odeline gains control. He's got a man. Near side, Wheeler couldn't control it. He has Valentini streaking towards the net. Valentini's going to go control it back behind the McKendry net. He takes a hard hit there by Poole. Valentini getting back up, though, and he'll get back ahead of three McKendry players. So Arkansas not too bad out of position here, and they'll set up their large box on the near side here. Odeline anchoring down the middle of that box. Right there at the top of, of the crease there. Grimminger, a pass far side, has a man shot. Northrop shot tipped around. Arkansas gets it, and Odeline lifts it into the air down the ice. Just over a minute gone, and this power play for McKendry. Still nothing to show for it. They pass one ahead. They've got Reek into the zone. Reek passes this one off the boards, backhanded, and Arkansas sends it back down the ice. Glove down there at center ice, and a pass broken up. Arkansas the other way. Parisi, the goal scorer last night, fires a shot. What a save by Bernardini. And a bad turnover by the Bearcats almost cost them. 3-on-2 back the other way now. So this is going to be Nelson making a turning move. He gets the puck stolen from him. Arkansas clears the zone, and having to retreat there is Brown. Baldwin with the puck. Baldwin, oh, kind of lost it in the corner. He's got a large man pinning him against the boards there. Reek. As that puck gets tied up, they'll blow it dead. It'll be a faceoff. The referee giving him an earful there. 4:31 to go. In this first period. Blandina, Brilli, and Wolf, top line here for McKendry. So Arkansas sends this one hard off the boards, down the ice, 6 seconds left in the penalty kill. Sukasawara levels a man against the penalty box. Gonna be tough to get out of there for the Arkansas player. Branscombe clears to the bench, and Arkansas is back to full strength. Centering pass broken up. Deacon's going to get this puck. Deacon lines up a shot, whiffs on it. Looked like he wanted to get that one on goal. Palmer hits off his skate wrong, and Arkansas will have to retreat again. This is Everett with it. Sends a pass across. A nice little sauce to Sugasawara. High slot, fires a shot. Blocker down. Rebound there. Valdrin fires it, and it's tipped just wide by Brown. As Reek puts a man on the ground there. Baldwin trying to work around man in the near side corner. Puck is pinned there. Three Bearcats, a couple of Hogs. As a broken stick comes loose. Arkansas going to chip that puck away from Wolf. And this puck checked along the boards. Picked up there by Patchen only momentarily. He slaps the shin pads of Palmer. Palmer able to steady himself. No calls here. Ref letting him play right now as this puck comes bouncing out front of the net. Kalmus aware and sends it to the near side. Everett's going to pick it up there. Everett getting the puck slashed off him there by Grosso. Grosso all over Everett. Puck sent around. Sugasawara trying to break out the far side. Sugasawara into the neutral zone, still pressuring that puck. And Arkansas sends that one into the offensive zone. They'll get a quick change here. Palmer hustling back on defense. Valdrin gloves the puck down. The rebound out front and a huge hit laid on in front of the net by Feltus. And a huge hit. Oh, no. There are bodies flying all over the ice right now. Two Arkansas players down. Branscombe getting in it. Moore and Palmer both down. And the ref. Sending a few guys off for fighting here. That was absolutely uncalled for by the McKendry player. Came in late. Absolutely levels Brent Feltis with an try to be as objective as I can here, but that hit that he laid on Zach Palmer was dirty. The puck is on the near side boards. Palmer's trying to skate back into a defensive position, and Feltis comes across and levels him. They try to sort all this out. Arkansas, I mean, they could potentially lose four players here. I mean, Moore was on the ice, looked like he was hurt. Palmer was laying on the ice, definitely hurt. He looked like he hit his head pretty hard. Palmer's up, and he's getting checked out by the trainer on the far side. Meanwhile, the McKendry Bearcats players come in. After Branscom tries to stand up for his man, so does Moore. They had a flying McKendry player come in, and that is the part that's uncalled for. We talked earlier about all this as they sort out all the penalties. Arkansas probably only going to have Branscom ejected here. Valdrin also at risk, as well as Feltis. Feltis's hit ignited a scrum in front of the net. A brawl. There were bodies everywhere there for a second. These two teams had played pretty clean hockey up until this point. 18 minutes, or should I say 17 minutes and 18 seconds gone here in the first period. This will be a long stoppage. A lot of finger pointing on both sides. Couple Arkansas players using this opportunity to stretch back out. Palmer using the opportunity to recover. Both teams got their shots in. They're trying to sort out all the penalties here. A lot of roughing. Two for Valdrin. Two for Branscom, two for Feltis, and looks like Reek is going to serve the penalty for the now ejected Cooper DiBiase. So Branscom gets to stay in spite of the fight that he was a part of. So after all of that, we're going to have three-on-three hockey. Coincidental minors on both sides. Probably the right call there. Unfortunately for Arkansas, Feltis's hit really ignited something there. That puck was well away from Zach Palmer by the time Feltis hit him. And it's not about the severity of a penalty, it's about if you commit one or not. And unfortunately for Valdrin and Branscom, they'll be sitting in the box for 2 minutes. So we got three-on-three hockey. This is exciting. A lot of space here on the Jones Center ice, something we don't say a whole lot
They'll have a face-off on the left side of Kalmus. We'll see who got energized by that scruff in front of the net. Arkansas, an outlet pass far side looking for Parisi. Parisi tips it into the zone. Parisi picks the puck up here. He gets checked down in the corner there by Poole. Poole looking for an outlet pass. Odelein hitting him. First period of action. This drama is going to unfold over the course of the next 42 minutes. Arkansas steals the puck away, offensive zone. Pass across, broken up, three-on-three hockey. Parisi comes in front. Backhanded opportunity is blocked down in front by Grimminger. Grimminger still checking on Parisi, who had a goal last night in overtime. The game winner is Odelein skating ahead. He's taking over the forward position as Sugasawara takes his D spot for now. Sugasawara gets the puck back. Arkansas looking like the better three-on-three team right now, which is strange because this McKendree team has a lot of speed. Reese, though, looks at Olay move around a man, lost the puck. Sugasawara picks it up here. Sugasawara, little turning move, backhanded pass. Arkansas probably going to be content just to let these penalties expire at some point. 48 seconds. It's all about puck control and three-on-three, and Arkansas has had it so far. Reese skating hard around the net. He tries to dump one into the net, but he knocks the net off its moorings. So he got dumped into the net. Faceoff will come outside the zone. McLean to take it here for Arkansas. McLean gets tied up here. 34 seconds left in the power play. Or I should say a three-on-three. As the guys get dressed in the box and an offside called here on the near side. McKendree, almost no offensive zone time here on the three-on-three. Arkansas just seems a little bit more confident in themselves on the three-on-three right now. McKendree loses this face-off ahead. Here comes McLean, offensive zone. McLean, a high slot shot. Rebound out front. Score! Shelfing it again is Zach Palmer. Good to see him back out on the ice. And Arkansas on the three-on-three gets a goal to put themselves up 3-0 with 59.9 seconds left in the first period. We'll call it an even minute as McLean again, a little face-off deep through, tries to take the puck away. McLean, very skilled players. It's taken away here. Offensive zone comes Northrop. Northrop, the first offensive zone time they've had in this three-on-three. McLean takes it ahead. McLean tries a little batting move around, and it's five-on-five again. Offensive zone. Northrop can't work his way through Palmer. Palmer, such a sure stick on the defensive end. The senior shutting it down. A couple of guys back on the ice. This puck comes into the offensive zone for McKendree. Marsh bats it around. Reek's going to pick it up. Centering pass out front. Puck is still loose. Comes in the near side. Grimminger shot saved with the blocker. Into the corner. 17 seconds to go in the period. Reek trying to put it out front. Grimminger shoves a man down. Arkansas back into the neutral zone. 9 seconds to go in the period. Sugasawara with the puck. Stick handling through. And it's batted to the corner. And that will end this first period of play. Arkansas enters the intermission up 3-0. There wasn't bad blood before. There might be some now. McKendree heads to their locker room to rethink their strategy going into the second period. Arkansas, meanwhile, has to understand that they lost the second and third period yesterday despite only giving up one goal in that span.
Now McKendry outplayed him during that time. As both teams get off the ice here, and they'll put 12 minutes on the clock for the first intermission. Don't go anywhere. Arkansas leads 3-0.
And we're back here at the Jones Center here in Springdale, Arkansas. Arkansas taking a 3-0 lead here into the second period of play. E.J. Sanders on the call. Alongside me is Quinn Shields on the camera. Arkansas out for their skate to start the second period. They had the better of McKendree there in the first period. I think it definitely flustered the Bearcats a little bit. A little bit of shoving there at the end of the period, about the 240 mark. Had a couple of guys get into it after a hit laid on by Brent Feltus caused the commotion in front of the net. The players have had a little over 12 minutes to calm their nerves and get settled back down. McKendree has yet to take the ice here in the second period. It's the long change period here at the Jones Center, and this is really where Arkansas's mettle gets tested every single week. Seems they have a boogeyman to get off their back. Still no McKendree on the ice. The buzzer's already sounded. Arkansas is getting ready for a face-off over here almost. Everett, Sugasawara, and Deacon, three of them, sharing a line today and sharing a lot of ice time as well. They will get the start here at the top of the second period. For those of you just waking up after watching the Marathon World Series game last night, it's the second period here at the Jones Center. And only one team has taken the ice, strangely enough. Not sure what's going on in the McKendree locker room right now. Arkansas taking the extra time to stretch out and skate. And finally, the first McKendree player enters the ice. They get out there, patching, skating around along with Nelson. They're all getting ready to go. McKendree gets back out onto the ice now, the full team skating towards the bench as we get ready to start the second period. As we said before, Arkansas a 3-0 lead entering this period. They're going to keep Bernardini in goal down here on the near side in now. They'll be skating from left to right to start this period, Arkansas from your right to left. Now, the way the Jones Center is set up, the benches are in the offensive zone for either team. So that's what makes this period so difficult for both teams is you risk going offside when you just want to get a change. You see the blue line. It's about halfway up the door there that enters the box or enters the bench right there on the far side of the ice. You can kind of see it there and how the Arkansas bench extends well into the zone. Same with the McKendree's bench, so it's pretty strange when playing games here. Penalty box also on the same side as the benches, and that certainly doesn't help. Deacon to take the center ice faceoff against Christian Blandina. A couple of sophomores going at it, and McKendree wins it back. They'll send it into the offensive zone. A weak pass sent across, and now a bank pass back to Odeline. Odeline banking it off the boards, finds Reese to break it out of the zone. He instead turns the puck over, and that's Wolf. He'll just chip it back along. Reese shelters him off the puck. Everett tries to pass along. He gets stoned there at center ice. Arkansas trying to get the puck back, batting it back and forth and back and forth. Finally, Arkansas controls it. Sugasawara in front. What a pass and what a save by Bernardini. Comes well out of the crease to cut down the angle. Not sure how he made that save. 30 seconds gone. He somehow gloved that one down.
Bernardini's made some stellar saves this weekend. Great job playing the angle there. A lot of goalies will just retreat on that and wait for it. Arkansas sends this one on net. Rebound out front. Stuka Suara missed the open net. Oh, on the near side. That puck came free. A wide open net. Another shot. Score. Oh, my goodness. Grant Deacon on the backhand down in the low slot. Gives Arkansas the 4-0 lead. I didn't expect it. The way that one bounced off the defender's stick, I think, confused the goaltender. Didn't look like Deacon got that good of wood on it. And it looked like it might have just deflected off the defender's stick in front of the net. That was patching. Trying to play defense there. But Deacon pierces through the defense and gets the fourth goal of the game for Arkansas. 4-0, a much different story here tonight. Or today, I should say. Blue skies out there today. A centering pass here by McKendry into the high slot. They're going to try to put one past the goaltender, but Kalmus shuts it down. Another shot from a tough angle goes well wide of the net. Comes back to the point. Reek will send it back into the zone. Picked up here. Palmer along the boards. Farinetta takes a hit on the far side, trying to dig it out of there as Parisi. He's got his man with him, and Valdrin just clears it to the near side. McLean, centering pass, finds Parisi into the offensive zone. Parisi, one of the best stick handlers on the team. Lays it off, and a shot there is sticked up into the netting. 18:36 to go in the second period. Arkansas a 4-0 lead now. Face off to the right of Bernardini. Gonna be Moore to take it. Got Branscombe and Jackson on the ice. Comes back to the point. Marsh sends it through the traffic. Skated aside there by the goaltender. Marsh can't hold the blue line. He was right there. And back the other direction. Offside. Going to have to check it up as Grosso turning back around as well. Arkansas near side boards looking to get it out of the zone. They make a D-to-D pass. Marsh has a man near side. That's Branscombe. Branscombe offensive zone. Skates through a man. Loses the puck. Jackson has it now. Near side circle over the faceoff dot. Jackson still with the puck. Sends it back down low. Popped up into the air near side boards right where that caution tape is. Another shot there by Higgins. Sent wide of the net. Higgins getting in on the action here today. Local boys. Moore gets it in front. Shoots. Scores. Another shot. Picks the corner, and Arkansas takes the 5-0 lead. It's not over yet. Arkansas wants more, and they look hungry for it. McKendry. A lot different posture than they held last night. You have to wonder what a win last night would have done for them today. As this pass to the far side, Wheeler dumps it back in for Arkansas. All the momentum going their way as Arkansas controls it behind the net, tries to chip one along for Valentini. Just missed the pass was Tilson. Back to the point. Odeline sends it down low, runs into the referee there. Odeline. Sends it back along. Odeline trying to chip it into the zone. It gets popped up into the air and out of the zone. Clears the blue line. Rees will turn back. Rees just lifts it into the air. Far side Tilson with plenty of time. Tilson centering pass. Misses the stick of Valentini and turned over defensive zone for Gay. Gay can't get it out of the zone easily. Arkansas will pin it in the neutral zone momentarily, and it's sent back down around the boards. Odeline. Olays one along there. Has Rees who misses the pass. It gets tipped ahead. Arkansas trying to knock this one ahead to themselves. Valentini down in there. Rees is going to give chase again. He's got Odeline behind him. Rees tries to play it off the boards to himself. It's stolen away in front of the net by Hagerty. Haven't seen Hagerty this weekend. As this puck is batted out of the zone. Arkansas going to lay a hit on there at center ice. Nice job by Nick Valentini standing his man up. Wheeler to Valentini. Valentini chips it along to himself. He works past a man. Valentini's shot easily patted aside into the corner. Centering pass. Tough angle. Blocker down. Tilson still with the puck. Grimminger all over him. Grimminger, the grad student, gets the puck out of the zone. Arkansas gets the puck away. Tilson centering pass out front looking for Valder. Now Sugasawara on the ice. Sugasawara trying to work it past the man there. Not going to do it. Back out to center ice. Brilli, a 3-on-2 the other way with Grimminger along with Wolf. Centering pass finds Wolf. Wolf couldn't control it. Near side, this one paddled up into the air and sent down into the corner by Blandina. Magnus sends it along the boards. Arkansas picks the puck up. 3-on-1 the other way. Sugasawara with the puck. He's going to line up a shot. It's tipped up into the air. Arkansas rebound chance. Gets cleared back to the point. Valdrin not going to let it in there. Keeps it in the offensive zone and it's steered aside. And there's going to be Aiden Everett getting mixed up here. Another ejection here for sure. Ben Patchen taking Aiden Everett down from behind. Took Griffin Sugasawara down behind the play. Aiden Everett's going to go to the box. Everett gets taken down. Patchen's going to get ejected. Arkansas wonders what they have to do. Everett's going to the box again. And I don't think he really deserves it in this case. Two five-minute penalties go on the board. I don't think Arkansas will feel too bad about this one, though. Up 5-0 here in the second period. Sugasawara is going to get checked out. Everett got taken down from behind. Talk to Rogers. They got to send somebody to the box on the McKendry side. Everett getting checked out in the box by the trainer as well. Off one back here by Arkansas as play continues. 4-on-4. Nobody in the McKendry box. Since it's a major penalty, they won't put anybody in there. McLean going to pick it up here near side. They'll send it back to the point. Scott Valdrin, a pass across. Shot sent back down around the boards. 4-on-4 hockey for another 4.5 minutes. Sent back to the near side. Picked up here by Nelson. Nelson, offensive zone. Lays a pass off. Shot. Saved down in front. And back the other way comes Arkansas. They got a 2-on-1. Parisi with a man right in his hip pocket. Sends it to Valdrin. Lines the shot up. Stick save. Bernardini. It's the long stoppages that do it to you. Seems like the energy gets sucked out of the building, but Arkansas able to get it back a little bit there. Couple of ejections for the Bearcats, 19 and 20 out of the game. That's Cooper DiBiase from Bixby, Oklahoma, and Ben Patchen from Palm Harbor, Florida. About the only two guys on the team that are from outside the state of Missouri and Illinois. Arkansas centering pass there, broken up nicely, and back the other way comes Blandina. This one comes all the way back down to the other end, picking this puck up. It's going to be fired to the near side to Deacon. Deacon looking to break out of the zone. Deacon with the puck, getting lined up there by Blandina, just sends it around the boards, hard around the boards, but then takes a
tough stop on the backstop there and picked up easily by Brown. Riley Brown to break it out of the zone. Brown with the puck. He stands 6 foot 180 and is taken away by Sugasawara. Sugasawara with a man in front. Chips a pass along. Just missed the stick of Deacon. He was streaking towards the net. And a couple of McKendry players get caught up. This is Sugasawara with it with control behind the net. Sends it in front. Marsh's backhanded opportunity goes wide. Higgins and Marsh on the ice. The D pairing for Arkansas right now as Sugasawara hits a man. Sugasawara wants that puck back. He chips it into the zone. He's got the puck. He's trying to work by a couple of defenders. He gets hooked down there. And back the other way come the Bearcats. They'll send this one into the offensive zone, and Grimminger is offside. That will bring the faceoff back to the defensive zone for McKendry. General Manager Chris Hussein getting an explanation from the referee about why they're not going to have somebody serving the penalty in the box. Really doesn't make a whole lot of sense if you're going to do 4-on-4. If it was 5-on-5, it would make sense. But Arkansas skating back. Odeline can't control the puck. A centering pass by Nelson, broken up by Arkansas. Far side boards held into the zone there by Grimminger. Comes back the other way. Over the Bearcats, back to the point. They're setting something up here, and a shot gets through the traffic but wide of the net. And now skating out with it is Farinetta. Haven't called Cam's name a lot tonight. He'll line up a shot, send it just wide of the net. Reese misses the puck, and it comes all the way back down to the Arkansas end. Odeline to pick it up here. Odeline just backhands one along the boards. Reese picks it up there. He'll bat one to Farinetta. Farinetta trying to work past a man. Reeked too much to handle there, but Odeline skates it easily behind the net, lazily even, and finds a man near side. Reese with the puck, and he'll turn back, make a stopping move, tries to pass it along, finds Odeline. Odeline to clear the zone, has a man near side just tipped ahead. Arkansas with the puck, more offensive zone on the forehand now. He tries to work by a little skate deke there as it gets out front, puck loose. Arkansas not able to get that one away. And back the other direction comes Brilli. He can't control it. He's going to pin Odeline against the boards. A hard hit, but effective as Brilli picks this one up. Finds a man in front. Nice stick handling play by Valdrin to get that one away from Blandina. Back the other way comes Arkansas. Parisi controls that through the contact. Good hit by Grimminger to break up the play. And back the other direction comes Brilli, offensive zone. He's got Magnus on him. Newman Magnus, little stick check there, stolen away easily by Valdrin. And a pass in front, picked up here. And Valdrin enters the zone. 1:23 to go on the 4-on-4. Back to the point, has Magnus. He'll line one up, shoots it through the traffic, rebound there. McLean never saw it, got caught between his skates. Parisi with it here. Parisi outer hashes. Parisi with a lot of room to skate. Don't want to give him that as Valdrin lines it up. Fires it just high of the net. Rebound off the back of the net. The puck gets picked off there. Back to the point. Going to be Parisi with it. Fires a tough angled shot. Blocked down nicely in front by Grimminger. And controlling it is Feltus. Feltus sends it around the boards. Arkansas almost had too many men on the ice. No icing here. Magnus going to skate back for it. Kalmus comes out of the net to stop the puck. Puck's momentum comes to a halt, and Valdrin restarts it again. He picks the puck up here. 4-on-4 almost coming to an end. Sugasawara losing the puck. Big hit laid on here on the near side. The Hogs get it out of the zone. The Bearcats send it back in. And a big hit laid on Magnus there. McKendry fans here tonight, you can hear them on the far end. Had a chance to talk with a couple of them before the game, including Dalton Wolf's dad. Good to see them in the building. McKendry plays a lot of road games. They've opened up the year with 8 in a row on the road, and it'll be 10 in a row next week as they take on Loyola Chicago. That'll actually be in 2 weeks for them.
Arkansas. Won the faceoff. And finally, we're back to 5-on-5 action. Puck sent around the boards. Arkansas not going to get it here. Gay's going to get it for McKendry. Going to try to pass one along. Gay still controlling it. Tough angled shot. Rebound there. And Kalmus picks the puck up. Off the ice. And we'll have a stoppage and a faceoff to the left of Kalmus. Almost halfway through this game. 10:32 to go in the second. 5-0 Arkansas leads. These two teams seem a lot more evenly matched. But Arkansas took our scouting report from last night on this goaltender. Shoot it high, and they've been doing so. About every single one of their goals has beaten this goaltender high. As Marsh takes a tough hit in the corner, a couple of bodies down, laying on top of each other there as Wheeler just tries to bat it out of the zone. Grimminger's shot comes fluttering down into the corner. Higgins fighting for it there. Higgins not going to get the puck away. Marsh and Higgins on the ice, getting a lot of ice time tonight. As Higgins takes a huge hit in the corner, Arkansas is going to bat it ahead. They've got a man ahead. This is going to be Tilson with the puck, offensive zone. He just works it down into the corner, tries to get past Gay, and Tilson takes a big hit, centering pass. Broken up here by Wheeler. Tilson trying to... They're going to send Tilson to the box for what? Tilson going to the box with Garrett Poole. Tilson's just trying to get free down there. Had his skate held by Poole. Tilson does nothing more than just kick free. He's going to go to the box. Coincidental minors. Don't know what you would call on Tilson there. I'm trying to keep this game under control. Sometimes you can have an adverse effect as a referee. Arkansas is doing their best to keep a cool head here. Kendry's already lost theirs. Collectively. They play hard. Right now, Arkansas with a 5-goal lead. They're looking for anything to spark them, and it'll be 4-on-4 hockey again. We haven't seen a whole lot of 5-on-5 hockey today. Arkansas doesn't mind the open ice. As McLean skates with the puck. A centering pass broken up there by Wolf. Arkansas takes it back, though, at center ice. Reese just dumps it into the zone. Glove down there by Feltus. And back the other way. Odeline finds Reese. Reese near side. They'll bank one off the boards. And lined up, a big hit by Brent Feltus. Puts Parisi on the ice. Arkansas has Parisi again near side. Parisi takes another hit but just lays this one along. This is McLean. He's going to work through a man. McLean, tough angled shot. Rebound was there right on the doorstep. Nobody home for Arkansas. McLean watches this puck skate by him. And this puck is held in at the point here by Reese. Reese ahead of steam, low circle. Gets it to the slot area but gets it knocked off of it. His momentum slowed but the pucks did not. McLean just bats it back into the zone. This is Reese with it. The breakout near side. Parisi reaching for the puck. Gets into the offensive zone. Arkansas right in their hip pocket, as always, but Wolf turns it the other direction. He's got a man with him, Brown. Centering pass out there. Kick saved by Kalmus. Arkansas the other direction. Parisi with it. Back skating. Controls the puck. Offensive zone. Parisi hits this puck towards the net, but not on net. Nice job by McLean coming away with it. McLean into the offensive zone. He loses the puck. Arkansas picks it back up. Shot high off the face mask of the goaltender. Just barely making that save. Arkansas comes away with the puck. 4-on-1 the other way. Another shot off the post. Valdrin tried to pick a spot. Just missed. Not by much. The ref letting them play right now. Sugasawara with the puck. Tries to work through a man. A nice defensive play by Feltus. Sends it all the way down the ice. And they're going to blow no icing as Kalmus came out of his crease. And Sugisawara, near side, he loads up a slap shot, and the stick breaks on him. It's unfortunate. Arkansas have a face-off in their offensive zone, in the McKendree zone. Face-off will be to the right of Bernardini. This one won back by McKendree. And it's 5-on-5 hockey again. A lot of bodies back out on the ice. Waldron skates it into the zone, almost gets it poked away. Instead, tries a pass in front. It's broken up and back the other direction comes Nick Nelson. Head of steam the other way. Palmer on him and a shot blocked up into the netting by Kalmus. 7:29 to go in the second. Seven and a half. To play in the second. Moore just sends this one back to Kalmus to cover up. Arkansas, good job here in the second period tonight. Today, still daytime out there. Trying to get used to these day games that the D3 team is scheduled. Arkansas can't hold the line. They'll have to check up the offside. This one's sent high into the air, back down the other direction, and that's going to go for icing. Face off here by Arkansas, kicked ahead by McKendree. A little wheeling pass by Northrup finds his man, but it's broken up here by Arkansas. Goes off of Gay. McKendree regains control. This is Grimminger, far side. He tries to slap one into the zone and does. It's steered to the corner there by the goaltender, Kalmus. Arkansas getting the puck back, has a man near side. Jackson to break out of the zone. He's all alone. Only momentarily as Grimminger almost gets a hit on him. Northrup, it's knocked off his feet by Branscombe. And Jackson pins a man in the corner. A good hit there. As it comes back to the point, Valdrin's shot, gloved down in front by Bernardini. Gets sent back behind the net. Arkansas will have to retreat. This is Valdrin. As Palmer near side, he'll just bank one off the boards into the neutral zone. And Gay with a head of steam, offensive zone. Gay skating ahead with it. Centering pass out front, finds Nelson. He'll fire a shot wide of the net. Not going to get many opportunities like that. If you're McKendree, you can't waste them. Arkansas looking for the puck. Farinetta mocks his man off the puck. Nicely done. Trying to regain his feet as Pool. Arkansas will get it here near side. They'll just send one hard off the boards, but kept in there by Gay. Gay has a man right in his hip pocket. As Kress is on the ice right now, along with Hagerty. And a centering pass sent all the way back down the other direction. Ahead of steam comes Farinetta. Cam Farinetta lining up a hit there. Decides the better of it. As Parisi sees that one bound over his stick and back the other direction comes the puck. Gaterman into the offensive zone. Haven't seen a whole lot of him this weekend. Arkansas just trying to chip the puck ahead. Pass Feltus, won't be able to do it. They'll send it down deep into the zone. They're not going to call the icing, and now they do. It was a couple of feet behind the red line. So Farinetta's going to have to stay out on the ice. And Parisi, McLean, Farinetta. One back by Arkansas. They send it to the near side. McLean giving chase. This puck comes right out into the slot. He shoots off the pad. Nice save by Bernardini. Arkansas pinning a man, and they'll keep it in the zone and covering it up is Bernardini. 5:10 to go in the second period.
Bernardini from Chesterfield, Missouri. He's a computer science major. Attended the Christian Brothers College High School. This puck won back. Grimminger's going to pick it up. He's from O'Fallon, Missouri. They got a couple of guys from O'Fallon, Missouri, and a couple from O'Fallon, Illinois. As this one's sent back around the boards. Picked up on the far side here by Gay. Gay's going to skate it out of the zone. And it's into the neutral zone and tipped back in there by Reek. This puck is still loose and goes behind the Arkansas net. Reek chasing after it. Marsh on him. Marsh undeterred by his size. Arkansas is going to pick this one up. Sugasawara gets lined up and pinned against the boards. Arkansas holds it in the neutral zone, battling for it there. Scrum along the near side boards and sent back down into the zone. Blowing a tire is Higgins. He picks the puck up, and he takes a big hit into the boards. And that's going to be a penalty on Golovko. He throws Higgins down to the ice. And a misconduct as well going to be assigned to Grosso. So a couple of guys going to the box. They're going to send three. I don't know if you've seen the penalty boxes here at the Jones Center. But they can barely hold that many. Standing room only in the McKendree penalty box, and Arkansas have a 5-on-3 power play. They were effective on it earlier. A misconduct penalty assessed to number 77, Grosso. A roughing penalty will be assessed to Dmitry Golovko. And serving the two-minute part of that misconduct, I should say. It's hard to see the number. They have somebody else in the box serving that part of it. Looks like it's Dalton Kress will serve 2 minutes of Tony Grosso's misconduct penalty, and it'll be 5-on-4 or 3. Hard to say. They might have handed out more than one misconduct. They're going to say it's 5-on-4. So Arkansas, just one power play then, but three guys in the box for McKendree. Send it back to the point, have Odeline there. He'll fire it through the traffic. Nice job blocking that one down by Reich. Sent back to the point, and another tip there by Reek, and it goes up into the netting. Keep mixing his name up. It's definitely Reek. Faceoff will come to the right of Bernardini. This one ahead. And Arkansas will get this one in the corner. Branscom with the puck, settles it, sends it up to the point. That's Reeves. Reeves back to Branscom, near side circle. He's at the top of that. Branscom skating down. He's got the puck. He lays a pass off. Farinetta rotating around him. He'll send a cross-ice pass, finds Odeline's stick, back to the right-handed stick of Reeves. Reeves down into the corner, finds Farinetta. Farinetta loads up a pass, comes bounding back to the point, settled there by Odeline. A nice no-look backhander shot there by Reeves, goes high in the net. Parisi picks it up. Parisi trying to work it back along. A couple of misconducts there being announced. Back down to Parisi. He's in the low circle, fires a shot. No rebound given up this time. Bernardini makes the save and forces a stoppage. 1:06 left in this power play for Arkansas. They'll get the Deacon, Everett, and Sugasawara line out there. This line has been effective all year long. With them, they have Newman Magnus at the right point and looks like Tyler Valdrin on the left point. They'll send it back to Magnus. Little tic-tac play. Finds Sugasawara's stick. Back to Magnus. Magnus loads one up through the traffic. Rebound there. Shot by Deacon. Goes just wide. Looked like got a little too deep in the pocket of his stick there. As Arkansas, Sugasawara shoots and scores. I think Aiden Everett tipped it in front. Sugasawara's shot tipped right over the shoulder of Bernardini. He drops into that butterfly so early, and Arkansas on that scouting report has just figured it out. Six goals plastered on the board by Arkansas. And with 3:11 to go in the second period, it's hard to imagine that Kalamazoo will give up that many on the other end. Kalamazoo coming into the weekend a 3.14 GAA and an 88.9% save percentage. You save 88% of your shots, you're going to win most games. Both of these goalies generally do that, but tonight, or today, McKendry has faced the bulk of those as a stick goes flying through the air. It looked like it got taken out of the hands of Nick Nelson. Back the other direction comes Wheeler. Wheeler just sends one down just to the side of the net, and a little backhanded chance in front, paddled aside by Bernardini. Shuts down the angle for any centering pass, and it comes back the other way. The Bearcats pressuring offensive zone, dug out of the corner here by Grimminger. He's down there along with Magnus. The puck's still not moving. Grimminger comes away with it. Arkansas trying to get the puck away from him. It's batted off to the near side boards and dumped back in. Chasing after its Poole. Poole's not going to get to it in time. Arkansas just going to work it along. It's pinned along the boards, far side. Northrop over there along with Wheeler. They get tied up. It gets back to the point. Gay's shot blocked down nicely in front by Tilson. This line not afraid to sacrifice their bodies, as this is Nick Valentini into the zone. He fires a shot. Rebound comes out front. Just went right past the stick of Tilson. I don't think he ever saw it. Another back-checking opportunity for Arkansas as they get the puck away, but back to the point in the zone as well. Blandina's pass in front, a shot. Oh, almost found the back post. Just comes rolling by. Waldron avoids a hit there from Blandina. Feltus sends this one high into the air, and he upends Valentini. Sent back ahead. Valentini's going to try to get this puck away. He's going to go for a change. Arkansas almost out of this period here. Three goals in the first, three in the second. Will we see some more in the third? Sugasawara laying a hit on. Magnus chasing after the puck. Feltus coming down low to try to get a hit on him, and they're going to say that one was tipped. Down the ice, no icing, as Everett lines a man up. Everett going to chase after the puck here. He banks one along, looking for Sugasawara. Everett tries to slam one on the wraparound attempt. Not going to get it. Marsh's shot from the point is punched into the air there by the goaltender. 1 minute and 4 seconds. Three, now two, now one. 1 minute to go here in this period. It's going to be Everett. Sent back around the boards. Takes a bad bounce off the stanchion if you're McKendry. Sent back down into the corner. Arkansas wants another one before the end of the period. Setting something up, but it's stolen away there by Blandina. Here comes Brilli the other direction. He gets lined up by Marsh, who misses on the hit. Centering pass out front. Arkansas not able to clear the zone. His glove down here. Back the other way comes Everett. Chipped ahead looking for his man, and Sugasawara is onside just barely. 27 seconds to go in the period. Arkansas can't hold the line. Higgins got to get back. He's got Wolf skating in on him. Higgins and Wolf. Wolf skates in front. He shoots. What a save on the back post by Moore. Skate. Moore ran into the goal, knocked it off its moorings, and it hit his skate, and he saves a goal. I don't think he ever saw it. Kalamazoo was beat. And Brooks Moore keeps it out of the net. Sometimes when things are going your way, you get puck luck as well. And right now, everything going Arkansas's way, 6-0. So Arkansas ties the puck up. Centering pass there by Reek. Arkansas just wants to clear the zone. They cannot. Sends it back around the boards. 8 seconds. Time ticking away on this period. Melts off the scoreboard. Arkansas will send this one out of the zone, and the period will end. Arkansas with a 6-0 lead headed into the second intermission. McKendry going to get off the ice here. Arkansas will skate to the far end of the ice with their goaltender. The refs confer at center ice. We'll be back in about 15 minutes for the start of the third period. Arkansas leads 6-0.
Center here in Springdale, Arkansas. Arkansas carries a 6-0 lead into the third period. I'm EJ Sanders. Alongside me on the camera is Quinn Shields as we get ready to start this third period of action. Alex Kalmus in net for the Arkansas Razorbacks and Joey Bernardini in net for the McKendree Bearcats. The Bearcats lost last night's game 3-2 in overtime, but a much different story here today. What was a very clean and well-played, exciting game last night has turned into something a little different this morning. It must be a tough turnaround. I mean, we didn't get home until 10:30, 11 o'clock last night, so you can imagine how these players have to turn right back around, wake up, and get right back to the rink. As McKendree wins the opening faceoff of the period, they got a lot of work to do to get back in this one. It's not unheard of to score 6 in a period, so Arkansas needs to stay alert and play tough. Arkansas on the forecheck here. Grimminger's going to take it behind his own net. They'll send this one around the boards and down the ice. No icing here. Chasing after it's Everett. He's got Golovko in his hip pocket. Everett tries to make a stopping move there. Couldn't get the puck away from Golovko. It's tied up now behind the net. Coming away with a centering pass. Comes all the way to the point. Grimminger's going to handle it. He shoots it through the traffic. No. Blocked down by Deacon. Deacon gives chase. Bernardini gets it from behind the goal and sends it around. Picked up by Grimminger. He controls the puck. Looking to break out of the zone. He's got Sugasawara and Branscombe checking on him. And Sugasawara takes the puck away, but it's chipped back out of the zone. Comes to center ice. Parisi chips it to the near side board. He's going to pick it up here. He's going to make a little toe drag move into the high slot. Fires a shot just off the net. Parisi still with the puck. Throws it down into the corner. Avoids contact there. Arkansas near side. Marsh picks up the puck. He'll send one back around the boards, but it gets poked out of the zone and back down the other way into the Arkansas defensive zone. Sent to Marsh. Marsh picks up the puck. He banks one off the boards, but it's sent back down the ice. Picked up there by Gaterman. Gaterman has gotten a lot more ice time. A couple of ejections McKendree's had to face, and a couple of guys on misconduct penalties still serving those in the box. Kalmus comes out of the net, leaves it there for Higgins. Higgins picks the puck up. The Springdale native sends it ahead. McLean not going to be able to get to him. Pass off and splitting the D-man in front is Blandina. He gets to the front of the net. A forehand backhand chance and then back to the forehand. Couldn't get control of the puck. So it's sent back into the zone. Magnus will skate that one down. Sends it off the boards. Finds Branscombe. Branscombe into the offensive zone. Makes a couple of head fakes. Fires it on goal. But an easy save there for Bernardini. 2 minutes gone in the third period. Couple weeks to regroup if you're McKendree after this game. We'll head up to Chicago to take on the University of Loyola, or Loyola University. And this shot from the point there by Valdrin steered away in front. A rebound opportunity. I don't know how Bernardini saw that and got to it. But back the other way comes Nelson. Nelson, offensive zone, fires a shot through the traffic, but Magnus blocks it down. Newman Magnus giving chase, now peels off to cover the front of the net. Another centering pass out front. The puck is batted around there. Northrop not able to shove it past Kalmus's glove. Now I'm running out of breath there at the end of that sentence. 6-0. 17:35 to go in the third. Face off to the left of Kalmus. One back. McKendree's got it there. Into the corner, Rees chips this one high off the boards. Magnus picks it up here. He's got an outlet pass near side looking for Valentini. To the offensive zone. But skating with it is Gaterman. He banks one off the boards far side. It's tipped ahead. And into the offensive zone again come the Bearcats. They'll move this one on net. Rebound out front. Arkansas just trying to clear it to the blue line, and they do. It crosses the red line and now the McKendree blue line. And they'll turn it back around. Trying to chip that one into the zone, and they do. This one's passed across, a D-to-D pass, and a delayed penalty here. McKendree will be taking as Odelein plays it off the back of the net and tries to push this one ahead for Farinetta. Hits the linesman. Wheeler just going to punch that one into the zone, and it'll be touched up for the penalty. A 5-on-4 as they pull the offender off the bench. Going to be Nick Nelson for slashing. Faceoff will come to the left of the goaltender, Bernardini. Deacon wins this one back, has Sugasawara back to the point. Baldwin tic-tac over to Palmer. Palmer down to Sugasawara, outer hashes near side. He's got Palmer at the point. Opts to hold the puck and now sends it to Palmer. Right-handed stick here. Forehands one along for Baldwin. Also a right-handed stick. A pass along just gets blocked down there by Reek in front. It's going to be Baldwin. Baldwin has Palmer. Palmer settles it down here at the point. He's looking for anything through the traffic. A block down in front there by Golovko in the pass. Just misses the stick of a couple of guys, including Deacon. Deacon, a little spinning move, sends it to the near side boards. Everett breaking up the left side of the ice. He's going to take this one into the offensive zone across the blue line into the low slot area. Skates it behind the cage of the Bearcats. Sends it back to the point. Finds Palmer. Palmer searching for a pass. Finds Everett again. Everett settles it down. Tries to work it through a defender. A nice defensive play. And this one clears the zone. Skating back towards Baldwin. Into the offensive zone. Baldwin still with the puck. Has Deacon at the point. Sends it back to him. Deacon covering for Baldwin's D spot. They switch places now. Deacon sends it down low. Finds Sugasawara. Sugasawara. He's going to want it back to the point. Finds Baldwin. Baldwin outer hash. 46 seconds left in the penalty. Rebound out front. Puck bumps bounding up high. Arkansas not able to finish that one off. Shuffled back along by Branscombe. And Palmer not able to hold the blue line. He'll skate back for the puck. He's got Baldwin on the near side. Sends it to him. Baldwin, an outlet pass, just misses the stick of Branscombe. That'll go for icing. 25 seconds left in the Arkansas power play. Almost 5 minutes gone here. Almost a quarter of the way through the third period. Arkansas 6-0 lead. They've been in control of this game from the beginning. Scoring within the first couple of minutes of the game and haven't looked back. Faceoff will come to the right of Kalmus. He's got a goose egg on the scoreboard right now. Branscombe plays this one ahead. Sent back down into the zone. Reese is going to pick it up here. Reese, stick-handling move, skates it back out in front of his net, sends it across. He's got Parisi, offensive zone. Parisi, stick-handling, back behind the net. Has a man at the point, backhands it to Odeline. Odeline trying to switch spaces with him. Sent back along, Gaterman's pass, stolen away by Reese, far side. The penalty expires here, 6-0, 5-on-5 hockey. Arkansas with it. Stopping move near side. Parisi leaves it there for his winger. And a pass back to the point. Settled down here by Branscombe. Passes one off for Reese. He's down in the corner, and he gets shoved off the puck there by Brindle. Brindle goes falling to the ice. The puck is still loose. Arkansas not able to control it. Tipped out of the zone there by Wolf. Derek Wolf giving chase. Skated along here. Picked up by Reese. Sent far side. Odeline to pick it up there. Back to Reese, near side. Tilson trying to tip that one back along. Picked back up by McKendry, coming back the other direction. Into the offensive zone. Poole tries to pass off here, near side. Played back along. And sent back down into the zone. Bodies flying all over the ice. Picked back up, Reese, near side. He's got a man, Wheeler, on the outlet pass. Just misses the stick of his man, Grimminger. Making a nice pass along, finds a man up, and a big hit laid on there by Baldwin at center ice on Wolf. Wolf getting up and on his own power and skates to the bench. Valentini getting lined up there. Grimminger shoves him off the puck. Nelson with it, banks it along the boards. Grimminger, nice little backhand touch to get it to the center ice. Logo finds Poole. Poole's pass in front, not tipped down in time. Northrop tried to get a stick on that. Tilson breaking out the other direction. Tilson, offensive zone, trying to play it along. Tilson gets upended. And back the other direction come the Bearcats. Gaterman with it. Gaterman, a lot of ice time here in a 6-0 game. Wheeler sending this one back along. He's got a man far side. Jackson has Tilson with him. Jackson passes it to Tilson. Back door, quick shot. Puck still free. What a save by Bernardini. He has been stellar at times, and especially on low shots. Seven minutes, 23 seconds gone. Third period of action.
faceoff. One back to Bernardini, and we'll have another stoppage. Faceoff to the right of Bernardini. Again, as they try to reset it. Getting on the ice there is Hagerty. This one, one back to the point. Arkansas just chips it back for Marsh. Marsh going to hold the blue line, slaps it back down low. Moore picks it up there. Moore trying to backhand one along, but gets it picked out of his pocket there and sent back down the ice by Feltus on goal. Kalmus plays that one, sends it over to Jackson. Jackson plays it along, finds Marsh near side. Marsh looking for the outlet pass, can't find McClain. McClain on the ice, and Jackson takes a huge hit on the near side, breaks his stick. As Rick hit him. Sorry, Reek. He's back to the near side, and Arkansas lining a guy up now. As this one gets physical again, McClain can't work past a man. Jackson took a massive hit on the far side of the ice. No penalties on either side. 5-on-5 action. As Odeline fires this one into the zone, blocked down. Reese sends it back on net. Tipped on goal by Sugasawara. Got a stick on the ice and got a stick on the puck right there. Looked like he was trying to angle that one over the goaltender's pads, but good positioning there by Bernardini again. Been stellar. 6-0 Arkansas. It's definitely not been his fault. He's made some immaculate saves all weekend long. Back to the point. Another shot, a high shot, glove down, sent here for Grimminger. Grimminger trying to work it out of the zone. He's got a man. Tries to pass it along. Arkansas will hold the line, and it goes into the bench. Rogers. Trying to discuss which faceoff dot to use. Odeline moseying back. Faceoff one back here by Arkansas. Everett just sends it into the zone. Picked up here by Gay. A D-to-D pass finds Gaterman. It's tipped into the zone. Everybody onside here. Hit lined up and missed there by Poole. Arkansas trying to get it out of the zone. Nelson all over the Arkansas players right there, and he takes the puck away. Nice hit by Odeline to stand his man up. Reese, good puck control, sends it to the near side boards and down the ice. No icing here. Chasing after it's Gaterman. Gaterman getting lined up there by Sugasawara, who levels him. A little pass off here. Down into the corner, Sugasawara with it. He's tough. Sends it back to the point, finds Farinetta. Another shot, and it's tipped high and out of play. 10:39 to play, third period. Arkansas matching the physicality of McKendry right now. McKendry flying all over the ice, doing everything in their power to get back in this one. And they will kick out the McKendry player from the faceoff circle. That's Blandina. One back to Arkansas player at the blue line. He'll send it around the boards. Parisi getting lined up there by Feltus. Feltus hits an Arkansas player again. Grimminger comes away with it. Grimminger sends it around the boards. Arkansas. Retreat and get this puck. Parisi just sends it off the boards softly. Finds Farinetta. McClain and Farinetta getting caught up. Farinetta comes away with it. Cam Farinetta banks one off the board. Sends it around. Wolf just missed a check on that one. Comes to the near side. Grimminger tries to clear the zone and does. Chasing after it is Dalton Wolf. Offensive zone. But a good job by Valdrin knocking him off the puck. Comes to the near side. McClain's going to pick it up here. He's got a head of steam. Not able to come away with it, though. Arkansas, far side. Valdrin trying to get back in position. He'll pin a man against the boards. Good job by Valdrin here. Taken away there by Blandina. Arkansas comes away with the puck. Parisi gets shoved off of it.
And Baldwin with the puck finds McLean. He gets stood up. McLean not able to get through the traffic. Grimminger, a nice play. A little spin move there by Baldwin. Not able to get a good shot off. Arkansas holds the blue line. Reese Wheeler trying to play this one along. Got taken away here by Wheeler. He can't move through, and he gets shouldered to the ground by Feltus. Out of the zone. Odeline, little backhand play, finds Reese. Corey Reese to the near side boards. This is Wheeler. Wheeler getting lined up. Wheeler, good steadiness there to hold, keep his balance after getting hit. Wheeler's got to retreat pretty quickly as the puck's picked up here in front by Grosso. Easily saved aside by Kalmus. Kalmus. And Arkansas getting it out of the zone, far side of the ice. Wheeler going to go to the box. Four on four yet again. Grosso going to the box with him. Four on four action. Arkansas has had the better of the four on four opportunities. It shows on the scoreboard. 6-0. Not exactly what McKendree wants here. They're fighting to the very end. As Golovko is going to come take the faceoff. He's got Brendel on the ice with him, along with Gay and Reek. This one comes back to the point. Brendel's shot, skated down there, and nicely done there by Higgins to take the puck away, and Branscombe skates it up the far side. Near side now comes Gay. Gay backhands one into the zone. The puck comes slithering along in the zone. Arkansas is going to pick this one up on the near side corner. Reek can't come away with it. Chipped off the boards nicely there by Moore. Moore trying to check this puck out of the zone. Can't get to it. Pass back to the point. Brindle shot up into the air to the near side corner. That puck jumped off his stick. And Golovko fighting for it there with Marsh. Coming back behind the goal to pick this one up is Higgins. Higgins skating out of the zone. Higgins on the far side of the ice. Tucker Higgins, offensive zone and offside. So Wheeler, the McKinney, Texas native, goes to the box with Grosso, the O'Fallon, Missouri native. So this one's one back, picked up here by Arkansas into the offensive zone. Nope, taken right back. That puck was tied up. And some skates. Now Magnus skates back for it. Magnus shielding a man off the puck, but sends it into the neutral zone. That one's batted away, and Sugasawara gets it back. So just looking for puck control in the last 8 minutes of this game. Skating into the zone now. A nice stopping move there by Feltus. But he gets stopped by Sugasawara. A nice little toe drag by Parisi through the traffic. Shielding a man off. Can't get it. But here comes Valdrin. High slot. Fires a shot and scores. 7-0. Normally in games like this, when it's 7-0, the goals seem routine. But tonight's game, or today's game, has been a little different. Each goal for Arkansas is that much sweeter for them. They are beating a pretty good team right now in McKendree. As McLean fires a tough angled shot, Bernardini. McLean having words with somebody. Looks like that's Derek Northrup. McLean shrugging his shoulders. The McKendree players. Arkansas wins the faceoff back. Valdrin finds his man near side. Magnus going to control the puck here. Had to turn and look for it. But does send it around the boards. McLean's going to pick it up there. Back to the point. Finds Valdrin. Baldwin has McLean near or far side. He gets it to him. McLean tries a turning move. That's a big man to try to get past, and he couldn't get past Gay. Keeps it in the zone, but then losing it out of the zone is Deacon. Magnus sends it back down into the zone. Glove down. And we're back to 5-on-5. Baldwin's goal.
Parisi with the assist. Comes to the near side. This is Everett. Everett, an alternate captain on this team. They send this one ahead. And it's banked back along. Far side and lined up. Nice hit there by McLean to knock his man off the puck. But Nelson gets the better of it in the end. He has the puck now. McLean trying to work past Gay. He's not going to be able to do it. Nick Gay stands at 6'8", 225. That's what he's listed as. He looks upwards of 6'9", 6'10 on skates. Kinsaw will get it to the near side. This is Everett. Everett into the offensive zone. Everett fires a shot. Blocked down nicely there by Grimminger. Chips it back to the neutral zone. Wolf giving chase. He's got a high motor. He never stops skating. And he'll take the puck away. He's got a man in front of the net. Opts to take it himself. Lays a pass off, and reading that one perfectly was Deacon. 5:51 to go in this game. 7-0 Arkansas. Deacon into the offensive zone, and they blow it dead for an offside. Jackson just a little ahead of the play. We'll have another stoppage. 5:46 to go. Face off. Finally taken here by Moore. He gets it poked away from him. Banked off the boards, back down the ice. Kalmus comes out of the net, acts like he's going to play it. Instead, Odeline controls it here. Finds Branscombe near side, and Arkansas is a two-on-two the other way. Jackson offensive zone. Jackson stick handling. High circle, fires a shot, blocker to side. And a big hit taken by Moore in the corner. He's able to get right back up. Collects his stick. Back to the point. Odeline has it there, sends it back down low, just misses the stick of Moore. Branscombe skating around for it. This is Arkansas's checking line. They send this one back around the boards. It's picked up there by Blandina. Blandina skating it out of the zone. A little move through the stick of Jackson has Brilli near side. This line's been very quiet after making a lot of noise last night. Brilli and Blandina on the ice, and they'll leave this one here for Grosso. Fires a shot, glove down, Arkansas steers it to the far side. Kalmus hasn't been challenged much throughout the game, much less this period. As Branscombe blows the tire, takes his own man with him, really into the high slot, and no chance on that shot. Goes well wide. Another tough angled opportunity, and this one's held in at the zone at the blue line. Gaterman fires a shot through the traffic, kick save. Near side boards, Arkansas trying to come away with the puck, and they will not. Back to Gaterman at the point. He can't control it, just banks it off the boards. Brilli to retrieve that pass there, but he gets knocked off by Rees. Rees for Arkansas, getting pinned along the boards. Falling to the ground there is Golovko. Finally coming away with it. It's the McKendry player and just steering it away from trouble is Kalmus. Marsh getting into it now. He'll pump the crowd up as he makes his exit. Are you not entertained? I'll tell you who's not entertained. Garrett Hagerty's not entertained. As he makes his exit as well, it will be quiet as the night. They'll send them both off. Those will be misconducts for both of them. Marsh throwing a couple of punches. The helmet coming off of Hagerty. The benches will be a little lighter when the buzzer sounds at the end of this third period. Both benches will be without a couple of guys. McKendry's going to be three short in the handshake line. Marsh will not be able to participate in the celebration at the end of this game for Arkansas. And the salute to the crowd. A few more people trickled in here. Had about upwards of 25 people to start the game, but as the game has worn on, few more people have gotten to the Jones Center. Probably up late last night, celebrating that OT victory by Arkansas before finally making it here. A lot of stoppages in this game. We'll take a chance to remind you that we do have a GoFundMe. If you would like to participate in that, anything helps. We're always trying to upgrade our broadcast, and we'd like to continue doing so. Calmus has one thing on his mind, and that's 4:05 on the clock. And a round number in the guest column of the scoreboard. They'll probably just skate 5-on-5 here. A couple of misconducts. No reason to take anybody off the ice for either team that isn't already gone. Misconducts will last the rest of this game as Arkansas tries to chip it along. Reek stopping the puck along the boards. A couple of big guys on the ice for McKendry towards the end of this one. Wheeler out there along with Valdrin. Valdrin gets tangled up over there. Yeah, well, you know, while we're assigning penalties, we might as well continue to do so. I think they've run out of room on the penalty sheet over there. I definitely have over here. 3:51 to go in the third period. Coincidental minors yet again, both for roughing. I think they're just trying to stymie any opportunities for another stoppage to break out. I think people came to a fight and saw a hockey game break out today. 7-0. 3:51 to go, third period. Wheeler skates this one into the offensive zone off the faceoff. He gets upended there. Arkansas keeping some of their more level guys on the ice out there right now, like Wheeler and Tilson. And Higgins as a shot's fired high into the netting, including the captain Palmer out there. Higgins getting some ice time tonight. Good to see him out there skating around. One of the only natives of the area on either of the Arkansas teams. Hockey is starting to grow in popularity in this area. So it's good to see a homegrown guy making a team like Higgins. And he works hard out there. He almost gets the puck away from the 6'8" Trevor Reek. Sent back down around the boards. McKendry's going to pick it up here near side. Grimminger. Grimminger trying to skate it out of the zone. Valentini forechecking on him. They are doing 4-on-4 right now. After the coincidental minors, a backhanded opportunity shut down by Calmus. He's been in the right place all day today. Grimminger can't get that puck to stay in the zone. Nice job by Valentini. Coach's son, Nick Valentini, watches as this one gets sent high into the air. He's going to go chase after it. Branscombe can't keep it in the zone. Pass off here, Grosso far side. Grosso offensive zone, easily steered aside by Palmer. He's got such a sure stick back there. And he just moseys into the offensive zone. Fires the shot well wide of the net. Comes all the way back towards the neutral zone. Arkansas able to dump it back into the zone. Grimminger settles it there. He is met by Valentini. Centering pass to Branscombe. Fires the shot, glove down. The puck comes back to the point. It's sent back around the boards, picked up by Valentini. His pass to the point, picked up by Rees. 25 seconds left in the coincidental minors. Just over 2 minutes left in this game. 2:10 on the clock. Arkansas sees this one come all the way down the ice again. They're going to say no icing. It was tipped. Sent back around the boards, finds Rees. Rees passes one off for Palmer. A line change here for Arkansas. Branscombe gets off the ice. They get Jackson and Moore out there for the end of this 4-on-4. Out of the box comes Valdrin, but the puck comes centered to the middle. Can't control that one cleanly as Nelson, and it comes back to center ice. Arkansas's defense was suspect at times last night, but they have been solid today. As Grimminger's shot has no chance, easily steered wide. Grimminger with the puck, skating below the goal line. Nelson with it. 1:25 to go in this game. Sent back around the boards, picked up there by Kress. Kress, it's knocked off the puck. Baldwin sends one far side. Odeline skating it. He just settles it down. Arkansas not looking to put any more on the board right now. They just want a minute to tick off the clock in this game to end. Odeline still with the puck. Going to send it to the near side boards. Palmer, offensive zone, they come. Sends it around the boards. Bernardini comes out. Settles the puck down. Tough angled shot, and Odeline's shot saved down there. Watching it all the way into the stomach area. That's the goaltender. Bernardini has 49 seconds. Show on the clock here in the third period. Arkansas, a dominant performance here. And this is against a very, very good team. McKendree, no slouches at all. They work hard. They skate fast to the puck. They get a little chippy with Arkansas, but, you know, Arkansas needs that. They need to be able to respond in adversity. And they have shown that they can do so today. A very young team showing a lot of maturity out there on the ice. Because they're going to get that Wheeler-Tilson line out there a couple more times. Newman-Magnus out there with Tucker Higgins. Higgins going to finish off this game. Sent to the near side. Wheeler watches this one come down low. Good job on the interception by Higgins. Higgins going to skate this one ahead. Higgins into the offensive zone. Higgins gets his pocket picked there by Brilli. Valentini gets pinned against the boards hard. 10 seconds left, 8-7. This one backhanded back to the point. Higgins just sends it back down low. 2 seconds, now one, and Arkansas comes away with the victory and the series sweep of the McKendree Bearcats. Arkansas moves to 8-0 all time against the McKendree Bearcats, Division III hockey club. Got to feel good to get a win in front of your home fans on a day against a team that really tested you in a lot of different ways. The scoreboard does not show how well the McKendree Bearcats played. The handshake line, one of the greatest parts about hockey, is once that buzzer sounds, you can become friends again. And Arkansas will skate to center ice and salute their fans. At the end of this weekend series, the Division I team will be back in town for a 3-game set next weekend. We will be here for the call. Once again, your final score, Arkansas Razorbacks Division III Hockey Club 7, McKendree Bearcats 0. For Quinn Shields, I'm EJ Sanders. We'll see you next week.